What's up, everyone? NeoCypher here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of questioning Friendship Finale in terms of how that was gonna go. Mainly when I had to lose roughly half my life points on the very first turn, because I had good options, just not for a first turn. But we survived, and that's what matters. Continuing my streak of, how am I doing this good at Arc 5? Seriously, I have no idea how Arc 5 is going this smoothly. Knock on wood. Yep, that was the story. Sonic Duck. Still not as good as Sonic Chick. But then again, what is? Oh, we got pendulums. Sweet. Oh, and he's using ancient gears. Okay, what do we do here? So basically got an ancient gear card. That was pretty much it. Can't set cards for the rest of the turn. Effects, okay. What do I got in here? So DDD, Cursed King, Siegfried. Tuner one more non-tuner, it's level 8. Non-tuner DD monsters. Use effects, channels per turns, cards of battle card effects, and the graveyard gain 1,000 for each dark contract you control. You know, DD. So we got a mix of synchro and fusion. Sort of. One DDD monster plus one DD monster. So I'd have to go synchro into fusion. If a DD monster you control attacks a defense position monster, inflict piercing battle damage. Once per turn during your standby phase, you can destroy all cards in the spell and trap zones. Woo! So I have to go from DDD Cursed King into DDD Dragonbane King Beowulf. It requires a DDD monster, and I'm wondering if this is the only DDD monster I have besides Beowulf. Okay, DDD Lamia, which is a level 1 tuner. If this card is in your hand or graveyard, I cannot talk during this recording session. You can send one DD or Dark Contract card from your hand or face up from your field to the graveyard, except DDD Lamia. Special summon this card, but banish it when it leaves the field. You can only use this effect of DD Lamia once per turn. Okay. We got DD Savant Copernicus, which is a one pendulum, but... Okay, so if normal special summons, then one DD or Dark Contract card from deck to graveyard, except for Servant or Savant Copernicus. In its pendulum effect, you cannot pendulum summon monsters except DD monsters. Its effect cannot be negated. Once while this card is in your pendulum zone, you can negate and activate spell effect that would inflict damage to you. Then destroy that card. Okay. DDD Chaos King Apocalypse. During your opponent's turn, if this card is in your hand or graveyard, you can target two face-up spell trap cards you control. You can now special summon monsters for the rest of this turn, except fiend-type monsters.
Also,
destroy the targeted cards, and if you do special summon this card, you can use effect DDD Chaos King Return Pendulum effect. You can banish two DD monsters from your graveyard, special summon this card from your pendulum zone. Not bad. Dark Contract with the Gate. During your main phase, you can add one DD monster from your deck to your hand. You can only use this effect of Dark Contract with the gate once per turn. Once per turn during your standby phase, take 1,000 damage. Ow. Okay. Forbidden Dark Contract with the Swamp King. Once per turn, You can special summon one DDD monster from your hand in defensive position, but its effects are negated. Once per turn, you can fusion summon one fiend type fusion monster from your extra deck. Using monsters from your hand or field as fusion materials, including a monster special summoned by this card with the above effect, once per turn during your standby phase, take 2,000 damage. I almost feel like there's a combo here I can pull off. So with Copernicus, I can negate one of the damage effects of these cards. Orthos. One spell trap can reveal one other DD or Dark Contract card I control and destroy them. Yeah, there is a combo here. I just gotta find it. So, pendulum-wise, I got a 1, 3, and a 4 for the scale. Not the greatest. That won't let me summon anything I got right now. This I can add a DD monster from my deck to my hand. And this I can special summon one from my hand in defense position, but its effects are negated. Okay, what is here? Getting to 7 and a tuner. Oh boy. Does this have any other nonsense? Okay. That's the only if it attacks. So let's see how risky this is. Because if I use Dark Contract with the gate, add a DD monster from my deck to hand. There's no restriction on the monster, so it can be a pendulum. With Forbidden Dark Contract with the Swamp King, I can special summon my DDD Chaos King. And then I can put out Lamia. That'll let me synchro. Okay, this is either going to be a good move or I'm going to doom myself. So let's go ahead and do this. Activate Dark Contract with the gate. Okay, that's a 6. I just want to see what my pendulum scale's like. DD card in your pendulum zone. Destroy that card. And DD Night Howl. A good pendulum would be nice. Once per turn, pay 500 life points. Target one face a monster opponent controls loses. This card leaves the field. Unless you have DD card in your other pendulum zone, this card's pendulum scale becomes 5. Okay, that's Orthos is 3. Once per turn, you can target one spell trap card on the field and one other DD. Okay. Okay, I got Orthos in my hand. It's another Copernicus. Holy! Okay, that's a 10. Let's see. You cannot pendulum summon monsters except DD monsters. This effect cannot be negated. Okay. Once while this card's in your pendulum zone, you can negate and activate a trap effect that would inflict damage to you, then destroy that card. So it's basically Copernicus, but for traps, with a huge pendulum scale. Let's grab that. Because then I can do this. Hang on, I need to make sure there's nothing else that's preventing me from doing anything here. Some monsters, okay. I don't think any of these say they have a restriction on me being able to place in the pendulum zone, so that one goes there. That one goes there. I can now pendulum summon everything. I really screwed that up. Oh, you gotta be kidding. I did the wrong pendulum monster. Okay, well, I screwed up. So I gotta go this way now. Yeah, I screwed that up. Hang on. It's cards in your hand or graveyard. You can send one DD or Dark Hunter card from your hand face up from the field except the enemy. Okay. Wait. If this card is in your hand or graveyard, you can send one DD or Dark Contract card from your hand or face up from the field to graveyard except the enemy. Special summons card banishing leaves the field. Yeah, I kind of goofed. I mean, ultimately, I'm still pulling this off. I just kind of goofed when it came to... I could have swore I was over the right monster. Well, we're going to see and pull this off. Card, I have one. Cool. Okay, this actually won't negate this, because that takes place on my standby phase. This negates it until my next standby phase. I actually won't do any good. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I made a bit of a mistake. Wouldn't have mattered. I mean, I can... Oh, boy. Yeah, this is gonna be a problem. Destroy that card. Okay.
Burner's effects.
Except I can't get like completely negated it. Okay. So let's do this. Target one spell trap on the field, one other DD Dark Contract card to control and destroy them. Might be a bit of a risk. All right, this is going to be a risk. We're going to regret this. So that's gone. I don't think anything low enough is going to make a difference. Let's get rid of you. We'll leave the pendulum zone open for now. Not my brightest move, but okay. So that's now. Veil Lightning Vortex. It's going to crash into me. That's fine. I'm okay with that. Yes. Actually, I can't go back on, but yeah. All right. What is in here? Okay, so the good news is I can probably do this now. Play some Pendulum Zone. Place this in the Pendulum Zone. Let me see my fusion again. If the DD monster you control attacks the fifth position monster, inflict piercing damage. Once per turn during your standby phase, you destroy off cards and spell and trap zones. Okay. He's going to be top decking everything from here on out. Discards in my hand, I can fusion summon one DDD fusion monster from my extra deck using monsters in my hand as fusion materials, including this card. Banish a card from your graveyard, spell summon one DDD monster from your hand. Okay, it's cards in my hand. Fusion summon one DDD fusion monster from my extra deck using monsters from my hand as fusion materials, including this card. So there's the catch. It's in my hand. I can fusion summon one DDD fusion monster from my extra deck using monsters from my hand. So let's Pendulum Summon. But not you. Because there was something that allowed me to get a card from my extra deck into my hand. That's probably where DD Swirl Slime comes into play. Straight up. Alright, let's see what he's going to be able to do. I'm actually going to let that 1,000 go through. Actually, let me see something here. I can negate the spell card. No. Trying to think what stops me at this point. We're just gonna go for it. Call it a haunted. I can't stop that. Yes, we'll continue to attack. No. So basically saved himself for a turn. Alright, I can't Pendulum Summon anything from there. Mm-hmm. go to battle. And he's got nothing left.
Yeah, that started out a little bad when I Pendulum Summoned the wrong thing. I could have swore I was over the right monster, but... that was a whoops.
So even sometimes, making a mistake doesn't turn out too badly. Like, everyone going back to their original dimensions here, or...? Oh, goody, now we've created a wormhole. Oh good, now we're in the Xyz dimension. Wonderful. So we've unlocked the next campaign duel, Rest to Revenge. The reverse duel for a vicious cycle. The... I'm probably going to mispronounce all three parts of his name. The Jean-Michel Roger deck avatar. I'm just assuming it's French. His ancient gear assault deck. How many ancient gear deck recipes have we unlocked now? Seriously, I want to see. The challenge deck for Age of the Paleozoic, and the signature card, Ancient Gear Howitzer, Ancient Gear Soldier, Ancient Gear Cannon, and 1325 victory duel points. 100 for the win, 20 for number of turns, 12 for activated spells, 15 for no traps, 4 for synchros, 3 for pendulums, 24 for difference in life points, 26 for maximum damage reflected, and 10 for inflicting battle damage only for 214 points. And thank you to his Call of the Haunted for ruining the whole getting his life points down to exactly zero. Alright, so I need to satisfy curiosity now. Seriously, how many ancient gear decks do we have? We got Ancient Gear Assault, Ancient Gears Explode, Ancient Golem, Ancient Perform Age. 4! I feel like we've had more than that. A lot of cards. Do I actually have... now I'm curious as well. Do I actually have enough cards for any of the recipes I've gotten so far? Not counting basic structure decks. Now, some of these are ones I've made my own, like... yeah, the ones with the numbers, I think, are either the basic structure deck or the one that I've made myself. Well, I'm starting to build myself, which we've gotten nowhere. Again, not counting structure decks. Gravekeeper, I've started making a Gravekeeper deck. Harpy Lady, I'm missing cards. So I can't remember if I've gone through a lot of this before, but just explaining some of the symbols, you're probably seeing at the bottom middle what it means. The wrench means it has less than 40 cards. You have to have at least 40 cards. The red circle with the line through it means there's limited cards, meaning I couldn't take it for online play. In other words, it doesn't adhere to the banned restricted list. The yellow triangle means I'm missing cards. The deck recipes are basically like a list of cards that are in that deck, whether or not I have them or not. Again, that's a structured deck. I don't think I actually have... that's one of them. Yeah. Strim. That was going to be my backup deck for when I was having problems with Zexal. If you are familiar with the phrase. I can't remember if it's actually originated in the anime or through Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged series, but that stands for "Screw the rules, I have money." It's basically going to be a like a dragon deck with a lot of blue eyes stuff in it. That was going to be my backup deck. But yeah, I don't think any of the none of the non-structured deck recipes I have are able to be used. Just the basic structure decks. Oops. Hang on. Wrong button. That's actually kind of funny. But yeah, so that is where we're going to end this. Again, that got a little hairy at first when I pendulum summoned the wrong thing, but again, minor mistakes aren't that bad. My plan still worked out. What I did, not counting the pendulum summon, was my basic plan. It was just, oh, I can get a pendulum monster out. Oh, I have a scale 10 card. Okay, I can make this even better. And then that backfired when I played the wrong pendulum monster, so I had to go back to the original plan. So the original plan still worked. Just the way I was going to make it better, I goofed. Well, with that, though, that's all I've got for this video. Hope you guys are enjoying the project so far. I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. I win this duel, you can't beat my rules. I'm in that groove, I know I can't lose. Your turn, your tricks, now what will you